Hi, Cliniko friends and family. I'm Rachel from the support team, and in this video, I'm here to share with you the most recent updates and new features that have been released in Cliniko this week. Our big changes include a new patient visit average and rebook rate that has been included in the practitioner performance report. We've also made updates to online payments, patient history, and account statements, plus a new ability to hide addresses for online booking and additional editing option for body charts. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. First, let's go over the new patient visit average and rebook rate. The next time you view or generate a practitioner performance report, you'll now see these metrics included on the individual and group appointments tab. Patient visit average, or PVA, is the total number of attended appointments divided by the number of new patients seen in the report's time interval. The higher the number, the more repeat visits a practitioner has. While the rebook rate indicates the percentage of bookings in the report's interval that have a future booking. This includes the total number of bookings, including canceled or unattended appointments, minus the number of patients without upcoming appointments, and dividing that by the total number of bookings. We also include some additional information or tooltips on how the data is generated. But just note, PVA and rebook metrics will appear on all practitioner performance reports, even the ones that already exist. So you do not have to regenerate previous reports in order to get the PVA or rebook rate information included. Next on our list are the changes to the patient history and account statement. Previously, generating a patient's history within their file allowed you to create a PDF that included a list of all treatment notes, appointments, and patient forms. Now, you'll see a list of filtering options so you can select only the information you need. This includes an option to set the date range, filter by practitioner or business, as well as indicate what types of records will be included in the report. You can now enable or disable the inclusion of appointments, treatment notes, and completed patient forms. Once you've filtered the history report, you can print from here, which will generate a PDF with the records you've indicated. While the patient history is a great way to combine all of your patient's treatment and appointment history, we recommend generating an account statement if you need to create a list of invoices and payments for a patient. We've also made a recent change to account statements, so they now account for partially paid invoices when calculating and displaying the outstanding balance. Now let's go over the updates we made to online payments. If you're using online bookings, your patients have the option to pay for their appointment in advance through our integration with Stripe. We have now moved the Stripe settings and the online payment setting, previously under the finances section, to the integrations page. We've also added the option to allow payments based on the appointment type. You can now select whether online payments for a specific service will be disabled or turned off, allowed so patients can skip paying in advance and still book the appointment, or required before the booking is confirmed. Previously, it was a bit of a all or nothing setting, but can now be controlled by heading to settings, appointment types, and editing each of your individual appointment types. If you have a virtual office or offer telehealth appointments, another great change we made is the ability to hide the business address in online bookings. This will prevent patients from seeing your physical location address when booking online. To disable the business address, head to Settings, Business Information, and edit the business you'd like to update. Under Display this business's address in online bookings, switch it off, save your updates, and your online bookings page will change immediately. As you can see, the address is no longer displayed and appears under other locations. Just note, your confirmation reminder emails will still display the address in the calendar attachment as well as your emails, unless indicated or removed. This can be changed by heading to your confirmation or reminder templates and removing the address placeholders. Now, our final change I'd like to go over is to our body charts. When annotating or creating your body chart, you'll now see an added pencil and eraser size. This new pencil and eraser size can be used on desktop, mobile, and tablet, especially handy if you're using a stylus or Apple Pencil. All of these incredible changes are now live, so let us know how you like them. Can't wait to share more exciting updates in the future, but until then, have a good week, Cliniko friends and family. Bye.